Okay, my only observation here is, my observation here is that Swapan Das Gupta said that she has certain support, she has certain support in certain constituencies. Dr. Das Gupta, you know, I can't completely agree with you because, you know, the BJP kept saying this, we will bank on her. And she's supposed to have support in Bundelkhand, Jhansi, Banda, in these places. She has, Dr. Singhvi, just 1 minute. She has failed to win a single assembly seat in any of these places where she's supposed to have such a strong base, which means you're not using her for a regional base. You're going to use her for something else, as Dr. Singhvi says, something which the BJP may have planned, but is not revealing.
No, please don't put.
Yes.
Mention anything about support. What I did say was that she is going to was Uttar Pradesh. How she is going to fare in Uttar Pradesh, make a visible difference to the BJP fortune, is now not talking.
Okay, we just there, Mr. Das Gupta, I am losing that video link with you. I'm just going to come back to you on that. I want to put that question to Vinod Mehta. Vinod Mehta, she has no visible base in these critical areas where she was supposed to have a strong impact.
Well, Arnab, the reason why she has brought into UP is that there is no strong charismatic leader in UP. And whether you like Uma Bharti or not, she is a strong charismatic leader. So in that sense, it seems okay. Secondly, I must again stress the caste factor. She represents a big hole in the BJP caste constituency, which they have filled up. Now, in what way will Uma Bharti campaign for the BJP? On what issues will he campaign? On what issues will she be most effective? On what issues will she have most credibility? Well, that's, you can say that she can talk about governance or she can talk about law and order, etc. But her natural constituency is the constituency of the right. That is where she belongs and that is where she is. So if I think the BJP would be rather silly if not to use her in her natural constituency and use her in some other way, then they'd be self-defeating and they wouldn't know, they would be using her for the wrong purpose and she would have no credibility there.
No, so Dr. Singhvi, is the Congress insecure because Uma Bharti versus Rahul Gandhi may just be a more interesting contest than Rajnath Singh versus Rahul Gandhi?
The Congress should be very happy. I think the Congress is and should be very happy. They should welcome the entry of persons like Uma Bharti. I think nobody in his right mind in this country even begins to compare a Rahul Gandhi with an Uma Bharti. I think everybody understands the inherently divisive agenda, both of the party she is joining and of herself. However you may mask it with big lectures on good governance, I think people realize that this country can be held together only by non-divisive agendas. They realize the sincerity and commitment of Rahul Gandhi, who does not preach from the pulpit, but is certainly infinitely more sincere than not only Uma Bharti, but several other Uma Bharti-like figures in the BJP. So I think we really should and do welcome such additions if the BJP thinks that these additions must come back to remind you of the unforgettable montage and footage are going to get them votes. But, well, then let's wait and see. I think they're in for a shock.
No, but I'm interested in this, Dr. Singhvi, because if the BJP veers towards Hindutva, it won't be limited to Uttar Pradesh. If the BJP veers towards Hindutva, it's going to have a national impact. It will force you to polarize.
Arnab, are you not being excessively charitable and unreal to suggest that there is a return to Hindutva by the BJP? The BJP never left Hindutva. Yes, at the highest, for short periods of time, for transient temporary gains in some regions, they've kept it under wraps. For example, I'll give you an example. They fought 800 seats recently. In Assam, in the whole of the 800 seats, they got about 5 seats. In Assam, they may have kept the Hindutva under wraps because it doesn't suit the territorial configuration. But nobody believes that it's genuinely anything except a temporary mukhota. So obviously in Uttar Pradesh, that's the agenda. obviously other parts, and I tell you, so this, the biggest problem with people like Uma Bharati or the contemporary thinking of the BJP is that they don't realize that India has moved far, far ahead. Every time they talk of this divisive agenda, which is their agenda, they are going to get it in the neck.
Mr. Singhvi, before I come to Chandan Mitra for a response, I want to get back to Swapan Dasgupta, who wanted to make a point. We are really talking here about the possible national impact of this likely swing towards the right.
Arnab, Dr. Singhvi pointed out earlier that there was a time when the BJP, in his view, took a tactical decision to eschew Hindutva and during the NDA government. But if you look at the Congress pronouncements during that entire period, they would say, oh no, they are really into Hindutva. Hindutva is their agenda. That is their agenda. So this crying wolf, maybe it's all right in terms of political posturing, but to make an accurate understanding of where a political party is actually going may not be very enlightening in that respect. And you see, the divisive agenda which he's talking about, you know, in his mind, it is divisive agenda. His father, for example, never thought it was divisive.
He was
a part of the BJP. You know, that's the reality of this situation. So the point is, therefore, you know, this is part of political rhetoric. Today, that old-style politics of the 1990 is no longer valid. I agree with Vinod Mehta that there is a very strong caste dimension in this whole thing. There is a very strong caste dimension. Uma Bharti's importance as a backward caste leader, Uma Bharti's importance as a person from a poor background, from an underprivileged background, which appeals to that. So these are certain issues, certain positioning issues. Now, how successfully she appeals
yes,
to it,
Dr. Singhvi.
How she manages to get to it is
not. Right to respond to Dr. Singhvi.
It is well known, Arnab, it is well known that a true sign of desperation is when a person tries to get personal. Well, since Swapan has started to get personal, I should like to stoop. But let me tell you that not everybody in the BJP carries a divisive agenda. Just because Swapan and possibly Chandan belong to that category, there are exceptions. And perhaps they fail to realize that my father might...
Okay, Chandan Mitra is...
divisive agenda.
Chandan Mitra is rebutting you again.
The only answer he can give, it means actually an admission of what I am saying. There is no doubt, but that people who claim to be editors or journalists, who come on programs claiming to be independent voices, but belong actually to a party, hook, line and sinker, should be the last persons to pretend independence.
Okay, I'm giving a line to right of response to Chandan Mitra. This debate is getting heated.
What's the point you're making?
The point I'm making is that the point you made just now in desperateness...
That the BJP includes people of various shades. That the BJP includes people of various shades. Therefore,
includes,
to lump everybody in the BJP
some,
into one category, in my mind,
some
is
very good.
You've just demonstrated it.
It includes some good and a lot of not so good people.
That's precisely, I'm very glad you said that.
Chandan Mitra is also rebutting. Chandan Mitra is also coming in.
With the same brush of extremism.
We're moving a little away, but I'll give the right to respond to balance the debate to Chandan Mitra.
I have very few and very limited observations, Arnab. Number one, I want to just recall something that Mr. Digvijay Singh used to say everywhere during the 2003 Madhya Pradesh campaign. He would say that he's really happy that somebody who's a maverick, he would call her all kinds of names and say that BJP has become his biggest blunder by making Uma Bharti the leader in the campaign in Madhya Pradesh in 2003. He told everybody that, you see, that has ensured that he will romp home for a third term. We all know what happened. We all know how the Congress got decimated in 2003. So, when Mr. Singhvi takes great satisfaction in saying, oh, we are glad that somebody like Uma Bharati has become the leader in UP, I am sure that the same result awaits the Rahul Gandhi-led Congress in UP. And on that point, I would also like to urge Mr. Singhvi that when he dismisses people by saying that don't compare. Yes, I also don't want to compare. There is no comparisons between Uma Bharti's life of struggle and achievement from the right at the bottom of the socio-economic ladder and coming up to this position. Mr. Rahul Gandhi, born with a silver spoon in his mouth, still doesn't have his facts right, as we saw in Bhatta Parsol. I'm sorry, there's no comparison between Uma Bharati's life of struggle and Rahul Gandhi's life of comfort.
I wonder.
And finally, I would like to say, let me complete. I want to say that it also does not behove the Congress party, which is the most divisive party in the country, whose general secretary calls Bin Laden Osama Ji and Baba Ramdev a certified thug, and has tried to divide the country, guilty of the 1984 Sikh riots, guilty of the Bhagalpur riots, and all kinds of divisive agendas, including the new NSC-led communal violence bill. They should not talk about divisive
politics. Dr. Mitra, I have not got answer to my moot question. Moot question is this, Vinod Mehta, why is Uma Bharti being brought? Is Uma Bharti being brought to win Bundelkhand?
Why not?
There must be a strategic intent. Strategic intent can't be Banda and Bundelkhand.
If you believe that a person who is not very popular among BJP leaders has just been brought back on a whim, then you can believe that. After all, bringing Uma Bharti back is a calculated risk in the BJP, because it's hardly a secret that she doesn't get on with anybody.
Arnab,
not with people in Madhya Pradesh, not with people in UP. So the party has taken a risk, a calculated risk.
Yeah.
And they think the risk will pay off because of her caste and because of her ability.
So what will the BJP do then, Vinod Mehta? Will it put all its hardline leaders, Sadhvi Rithambara and the rest, also to join a new kind of campaign for Uttar Pradesh? Or will they keep
it
very subtle?
They will deny that, but if you... It's an inference that you can draw that if there is an Uma Bharti in the UP campaign,
yes,
what kind of campaign it's going to be? I don't want to say anything more than that because I have no evidence for that. But what kind of campaign will Uma Bharti fight? I mean, you must ask yourself.
Swapan Das Gupta says nation has changed, Uma Bharti has changed.
Arnab?
Yeah, well, I believe that.
Arnab?
I believe that. I mean, if you're going to conduct a campaign along 1991 lines, it's a bit of a no-hoper.
Okay.
Politics in
Abhishek.
Uttar Pradesh has moved considerably.
Okay. Abhishek Singhvi, yes,
Arnab.
Quickly. Yes.
I was delighted to hear Chandan Mitra singing pines of praise about Uma Bharti a while ago. I was wondering, when he was singing those great praiseworthy adjectives, why was he forgetting all that praise for the last 5-6 years? If you actually rewind, you will find, apart from the visuals, verbally, the maximum abuse from BJP and Mr. Advani and other people in the BJP against Ms. Uma Bharti and vice versa. Suddenly she has become the paragon of virtue. And I agree with him, there is no comparison between the divine and the comic, between absolutely known...
Oh, Mr. Rahul Gandhi is the divine!
And last but not the least...
Is Rahul Gandhi the divine?
Divine rights to rule.
She's certainly the comic.
Rahul Gandhi
is certainly the comic.
That's it.
Is Rahul Gandhi divine?
He's God.
No, certainly the comic. And,
no, that's
and
a, that's
I'm
a,
glad Dr. Singhvi, you called him divine.
We are talking of divisive politics. Who has got the history of India, etches the so-called Ayodhya Yatra, and then this big speech about the saddest day of my life. The history of India has nothing to compare with Gujarat and Godhra. The history of India has nothing to compare with each and every divisive policy, and they are telling us, preaching to us about divisiveness.
No, but Swapan Das Gupta made a point. Yes,
the heart
Arnab,
and soul
Arnab,
of that
Arnab,
right-wing
let me
fascist
track.
Agenda.
Let me
of that right-wing
track.
Fascist agenda.
Let us not talk about divisive politics. Let us talk about the divine politics of Mr. Abhishek's
picking
Singhvi. Now let him expound the divinity of Sri Rahul Gandhi. We'll be delighted to hear.
I think both you and Swapan Das Gupta have caught on that point. And I can see Swapan Das Gupta taking great delight.
What do you expect?
In that particular point here. What do we expect? I don't know. I just want to know what turn national politics will take with the return of Uma Bharti. Swapan Das Gupta, Chandan Mitra and Abhishek Singhvi, Vinod Mehta, for that delightful debate. Thank you so much.